let's get started. So yesterday we had a brief discussion on what is time series and probably what's time series analysis about. Today I'm going to talk about what are the specific challenges. Again, today you'll not see any equations per se. That's a typical strategy to make sure that, to make you believe that time series can be learnt without equations, but that's not the case. Gradually we'll spruce up the number of equations that come up and so on. Anyway, not to scare you, first it's important to gain a conceptual understanding of what the subject is about, and then that will also give you an opportunity to decide for instance whether this course is for you. And secondly, maybe it will give you some ideas which you have never come across. So that's the objective with which we are going over an equation less and more of a conceptual understanding of time series analysis. What we will now specifically focus on is what are the challenges in time series analysis, and that's what is the thing that we need to know, because then it will tell us as to what kind of complexities we will have to face and what are the problems that we will encounter. So the key challenges in time series analysis are randomness and uncertainties. These are the two things that makes a subject very special, very challenging, and it has continued to intrigue researchers for several decades. You can, if you look at the history of time series analysis in the open literature, dates back to at least 1920s, and then there was a flurry of activity, a lot of momentum somewhere in the 30s, 40s and so on. And what we are learning today is essentially the essence of whatever has been worked out somewhere from 30s to 60s, with of course a lot of other embellishments and developments in the subsequent years. These two are actually divine, because they help us carry on with our jobs, they help us get jobs. Because imagine if randomness or uncertainty was not there in the world, then a single person would have been capable, or a few people would have managed to predict everything, and then the rest would be jobless, there would be nothing to be excited about and so on. The good thing about this randomness and uncertainty is that nobody knows the truth, okay, which is a very nice thing. All of us are actually trying to inch closer to the truth. We believe that we are somewhere around the truth, and then somebody comes along and says, no, you are millions of kilometers away from the truth, and that saga continues. So in that sense it is divine, and that's why I say every morning you should worship uncertainty and randomness, because without which you wouldn't be, we wouldn't be carrying on with our lives. Of course it has its own cons, but we'll not worry about that. Why are these two things making the time series analysis very challenging? First of all, what is meant by randomness? All of us have some misconception or some conception about this term randomness, right? Let me actually take a sample on what thoughts you have when you hear the term randomness. Maybe randomly pick one student here, maybe if somebody in the other hall wants to answer also, he or she is welcome. So let's ask around at least a couple of students as to what they, he or she thinks about randomness. Anyone?
Which is not planned or organized.
You should raise your hand, I said. Sir.
Which is not planned or organized.
Okay. Like what we went today. He says, yeah, my goodness. So much planning, you can still have uncertainty. So obviously, I mean, it's not that we have not tested. We have tested many a times, but still uncertainty can come in and say, I'm the boss, right? So, it's got not to do with planning. Anything else?
There is no order.
There is no order.
Like a fixed, how something as in the after A, B, C, it can be random.
Okay. That you can't really say D will come, right? Could be Z also. Okay.
Can be predicted.
I'm sorry?
Can be predicted.
You can't,
it,
what is that it? It cannot be predicted would mean what? What is that it? Are you referring to the it as a part of IIT? It? What is that? No, I know what you mean. I just want you to be more clear, that's all. Sorry? Yeah.
A
the output, like the bias variable, it doesn't follow like a pattern or
okay.
Will be a random variable.
Okay. Anybody from that hall wants to answer on what is randomness? Because this is a key to understanding randomness, is a key to enter the world of time series analysis.
You don't know what the result is going to be before you do it, the experiment.
Okay. Okay, not bad. Any other answer from that hall? We are already into the world of approaches. You are probably a step ahead in terms of explaining how to deal with randomness. We are not asking how to deal with randomness. We just want to know what is randomness. What do we mean, for example, by a random variable or a random signal? These are the terms that we keep hearing, right? So, somehow we have some notions about random signal. For example, a few think that random signal is not predictable and so on. So, one final answer from any of the halls. Sorry?
Chance may or may not happen.
Now, that is the standard misconception. So, we will, okay. So, thank you. Now, all of you have given some inputs which are partly right, okay. It is not fully right, does not fully explain what is randomness. There are several ways in which one can describe randomness, but definitely randomness, when we talk of a random process or a random signal, it does not mean that a signal may exist or may not exist, or a process may produce an outcome or not. It has got nothing to do with that. So, the randomness is not about the event itself, event per se, but the randomness is about the outcome of the event. So, one has to be able to distinguish between the outcome and the process itself. A random process by definition exists forever. It always exists, because if it ceases to exist, there is going to be a contradiction which we will realize later on. So, a random process exists forever. Its outcome, in the simplest term, if you want to say, is unpredictable. I mean, that is a vanilla definition. We will actually refine that definition as we go along. But from a prediction viewpoint, and it is useful now to start developing this perspective of prediction. From a prediction viewpoint, a random process is one, or a random signal is one, whose outcome you can say, or the value that the signal takes at the next instant is cannot be accurately predicted. So, you have to notice that I said cannot be accurately predicted, I never said cannot be predicted at all. So, there is a difference between accurate prediction and just not be able to predict at all, as you will see later on when we get into the math of time series analysis or the stats of it. You will realize that there is a huge difference between these two situations. Now, from another perspective, randomness actually means that there is no precise mathematical function to describe that process. Some of you have actually pointed it out, which is correct. I cannot, for example, somebody said, well, if I am given that A, B, C and has occurred, then I cannot say accurately that D is going to follow A, B, C. Something else can come up, right? So, this is a hallmark feature of any random process. It puts us in a weak spot. We are unable to actually predict accurately. It does not mean that we cannot predict at all. For example, if you have seen it is raining, if you know the rainfall pattern in a particular city, then if I ask you whether it is going to rain, or if you have seen the temperatures dropping, the air is cooling down, clouds are in the sky, and if I ask you whether it is going to rain, then obviously, you can say, no, I do not know, it is a random process, it may or may not rain. That cannot be the stance. Yes, that is true. While it is true that it may or may not rain, as practitioners, we cannot take that stance. Will you do that? In reality, you will say, I do not know if it is going to rain or not, despite I see clouds, black clouds forming in the sky, the air is cooling down and the temperatures have dropped. We will not take the stance that, no, it may or may not rain, right? I mean, we are not running into a Lagan-like situation where everything comes and then the song is over and the clouds go away, okay. It is not like that. It is you can predict, but there is going to be an uncertainty associated with that prediction. Even there, we are not 100% confident that it will rain. It can happen that despite all these conducive situations for rainfall, that the clouds will go away and it won't rain. It can happen. So it is that other thing that can happen makes the process random. We cannot say accurately. On the other hand, if I say that I hold this and I leave, right? How many of us believe that it won't fall up and rather fly upward, fall down and fly upwards? Anyone in this hall or the other hall believes that it will fly upwards? Anybody? You probably don't know I'm a magician. Maybe I have a button here which will actually let it go up, right? If I release it, what is your prediction? It'll fall. How sure are you? Mostly, somewhere you want to give yourself a chance, correct? So obviously, if I release it, it has fallen. Okay, so you're right. So that you don't want to call a random process because you believe that there is a remote chance that it can fly upwards. We call that as a deterministic process. In fact, a better technical term for that is predominantly deterministic. That is, yes, there is somewhere, you know, somebody said mostly. Yes, somewhere there is some uncertainty troubling our minds, but we're pretty sure. That is how an engineer should be, in the sense that is the stance that an engineer should have to be practical. There is no ideal deterministic process, that's for sure. A deterministic process is one which can be accurately predicted, whose course can be accurately predicted. There is no, it's only an idealism, but that idealism helps us in defining what are non-deterministic processes. So there are different terms that you will encounter in the literature, non-deterministic, random, stochastic, and so on. There are, of course, some subtle differences between random and stochastic. We will not observe those differences today or even in the course. So the point is that in general, any process will be characterized by some uncertainties. The question is to what extent. Now, all of these discussions that we are having and more were actually a part of the initial developments in time series analysis. Many researchers really spend enormous time in trying to come up with a definition of random process. We'll discuss that technical definition later on. And that definition today is attributed to Wold, W-O-L-D. He was a pioneer in random signal processes and time series analysis. His definition of what a random process is or what a non-deterministic process is kind of the gold standard today. We'll come across that a bit later on. But the fact is that a random process is one which cannot be predicted accurately, but it doesn't mean, number one, that it may exist or not. That definitely is not there. That's out of the definition. It's not there. But there is a situation, I mean, there are a class of random processes which cannot be predicted at all. What we mean by this is, given any amount of history of the random process, you cannot actually make an improvement over the average. The simple average is the best prediction for such processes. We call such processes as ideal random processes. Engineers call them as white noise processes for a reason that we'll know later on. So there is an ideal random process, and then there is an ideal deterministic process. In reality, we would be dealing with either an ideal random process because we don't know. We'll only figure out from data. That's what time series analysis is about. The first step typically in time series analysis is about figuring out whether we are dealing with an ideal random process, that means which offers no scope for prediction, or it offers some scope for prediction, and also to figure out if there are any deterministic trends. For example, if you were to go back to the stock market index series that we saw, yesterday. So if you look at the bottom left here, the Swiss stock market index that we saw, you see that there is a trend, correct? We do not count those trends as a part of the random process. We imagine this random process to be made up of two components, a deterministic component and a stochastic component. So you can see over and above the trend, there are some irregularities, correct? those irregularities are constituted, or they, we assume that they constitute the stochastic part, and the trend that you see is attributed to the deterministic part of the, or the nature of the process. And you will see many such series where it's the series is a mix of deterministic and stochastic, and also many series where you don't see a deterministic component, you deal with as a pure stochastic. I'm not saying ideal stochastic, a pure stochastic, where there is or there is not a possibility of making a prediction. Generally, the best prediction that you can make of any random process is the average. That is, if you are not given any history at all. When there is no scope for improving upon this average, we call such processes, random processes, as ideal random process. If the history of the random process has something to tell you, improve upon the prediction, that is improve upon the average, then we say that yes, you know, I am going to build a model and make some forecasts. Any model that I will build for a random process will still fall short of predicting accurately. That is the main, I would say that is the core of Wold's definition of a random process. That is what distinguishes between a deterministic and a random process. For a deterministic process, if I were to give you the infinite history, we are talking about theory, so we will talk about infinite history. If I were to give you the infinite history of the deterministic process, you will be, your prediction of what the process is going to be at the next instant is going to be spot on, accurate. Whereas with a random process, even if I were to give you infinite history, your prediction will still be inaccurate. That means there is going to be an error between what you predict and what you will observe of the process at the next instant. So that's the fundamental difference between a deterministic and a stochastic process. Okay.